Yes.
In the school setting, I found that this opposite was true in not as deeper, not in deep issues, but in personal responsibility issues of it's the teacher's fault, they're not passing, it's everybody's fault but their own.
Right.
How do you attack that kind of a problem?
And I'm like, well, and they're like really adamant about it. And they're like, well, it wasn't my fault. I'm like, so when you're in school, all these people are working against you. Yes. So when you're playing sports, all these people are working against you. And they're like, yeah. I'm like, this is an amazing conspiracy, how everyone is spending all their time trying to figure out how to screw up your life. Well, yeah. I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm like, do you honestly believe your teacher gets up and thinks, okay, how can I screw with Johnny today? So I would kind of go that route, or I'm like, well, what are you doing to prevent it? Because like, if they don't get that, because I'll use a lot of humor when I confront the kids. The other thing is they're like, well, teacher isn't fair to them. And I'm like, okay, yeah, you're right. Now what? And they're like, no, really, they're not fair. I'm like, okay, you've convinced me they're not fair. How are you gonna handle it now? You've convinced me. You're right. Your teacher's not fair. Is working against you. Is purposely trying to fail you. Now what? And they're like, well, what do you mean? I'm like, well, you can sit here and continue to like bitch and moan about it, or we can try to come up with something and how you're going to handle it. It's like, are you giving, like, because I'll take it from their stance. Are you giving the teacher reasons to fail you? No. I'm like, really? Any missing assignments right now? Four. How about getting your assignments in on time? I bet you it'd be a little bit harder for your teacher to fail you then. How often are you like smart enough to her talking back in class? Well, a lot. You know what? If she's wanting to fail you, you're giving her every opportunity to do it. So you're gonna let her win and you're gonna lose. I go, and the only thing dumber than you're letting that happen, this going on, is that you're helping it going on, so you get to take the class over and go through it again next year. Good plan. And so then they're like, what? And I'm like, the best way to piss off your teacher, get everything in, be polite, answer her questions, and give her absolutely or him no reason to get you in trouble. If they're really trying to get you in trouble, that's going to bother them. And they're like, okay. So I would either show how irrational it is that they're saying all these people are going with it, or I'll just go almost the complete opposite. Go, okay, you convinced me, now what? And they're like, no, they're really doing this. And I'm like, yeah, you're right. We still got to come up with a solution. So that's probably where I'd go with that, situation. Okay. All this ties into, like I said, the negative self-talk, that internal monologue that we have going on. And if you really start monitoring what you say to yourself, it's amazing. I swear, if that was a person walking behind you saying these things, you would punch them. You'd be like, shut up, go away, and leave me alone. I mean, and some of these kids, they really, really have this bad. It ties very closely with the irrational thoughts. The shoulds, the musts, the have to, the nevers, the always. When you get these like all-inclusive phrases being said, either to yourself or when kids are saying it to you, 9 times out of 10, it's an irrational thought. They're always unfair. They're always out to get me. My parents never listen to me. I'm like, no, that's probably not true. No, they never listen. I'm like, I point out where they have. No one likes me. No one in the school likes me. I'm like, really? So when you get those, you're pretty much looking at it irrationally. You want to pull them back from that. Again, the shoulds, the musts, the nevers, the always, things along those lines. The guilt and the putting ourselves down. It's never forgiving ourselves. Like, again, the best question to ask, I'm like, if your friend had asked you for forgiveness and you're like, oh yeah, that's all right, dude, don't worry about it. Would you mean that? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, so they said it to you, why can you not accept it? Why can you not let yourself off the hook? You do it for other people, why not yourself? That usually gets them pretty well.